Thumbs up, you two, if you're good. Okay, raise it up, please. The answer is, yes, the answer is call me what? It. Wait. Today is going to be about a contest. It's a trivia question, okay? And you're gonna have a paper, and on every piece of paper, you're gonna write your answer with it on a marker. But make sure to write it big enough so that I can see the answer. Every time you get it right, you stay on it. This is a survival game. Like, you get the answer right, you stay on it. Every time you lose, though, you will be out. You'll have to log off. So this is a survival game. Every time somebody's done, you're done. Okay, so it's a survival game. So at the end, we're gonna have just like a one video and of the winner, and then that winner will get a special prize. So what are the prizes? You know what, because you guys are stuck at home, if you happen to have a Fortnite, this will be your prize, okay? At the same time, if you don't have Fortnite, that's okay. We can transfer that fund to any of the gift card that you wish to have. Do we understand on that one? Does everybody understand on that one?
Mm-hmm.
All right, so, but remember, only one winner, and how much? It really depends on like how really enthusiastic you are. So, I want you to give me a good like cheer and say like, yeah, we're gonna do this game, yeah, we're doing it, wow! All right. I thought Cody was about to be out because like, he didn't say anything. No, I'm kidding. And I'm gonna do a practice question. Do we understand? Here is the practice question. So you got your marker ready?
Paper
ready,
right? How hard is this gonna be?
Huh?
How hard is this gonna be?
Oh, okay, that's a good question. I will start from level one question, something that is hard to miss. First question, all the way down to the hardest. Okay, so level one through level four. A practice question. Our school mascot is A, mermaid, B, merchants, C, Maleficent, D, Merlins. Thumbs up if you're done. Raise up your panel. Raise up your panel.
What?
The answer to the question is, Miss Eswine, you've been in our school long enough. What is the answer to our questions?
Merlins!
Yay! It's a Merlin. So how many of us got it right on the Merlins, guys? Yes! Now, it's the real questions. Are we ready? Yeah. Our after-school club is called MCA. It is called McNeill Cinema. And what? The spelling has to be correct. C art. All right, so raise up your panel right now. I want you to raise up your panel. How many of you got C art right now? C art. C art. All right, C art. Great job. Everybody got it correct. So everybody survive on this level. Show me a round of applause. Yes, for that one. All right, cool. All right, so here's the next question now. Are we ready? Right now, we can't go to school due to the spread of this pandemic virus. What is the official name of this virus? Show me your panel and the questions. I want to see it right now. Everybody show me your panel. I am seeing everybody's right now. All right, raise up again, please. I want to see it, everybody's. Cool.
COVID-19.
COVID-19. Yes, that is correct. Do anybody know why is it called COVID-19? Yeah, CO stands for Corona. Very good, Ava. And the VI stands for?
Virus.
Virus, yes. CO stands for Corona, VI stands for virus, and D is for?
December.
No, December stands for a disease. But you're almost correct there because it did happen, it was discovered around December, right? So the 19 stands for the year when the virus was first discovered, which was 2019, okay? Next trivia question. The MCA is currently divided into two groups. The first group meets on every Monday. When does the other group meet? Quickly move on. Thumbs up if you guys are done. Some people are still writing on it right now. Thumbs up. The answer was, Sarai, what was the answer?
Thursday.
The Thursday, yes. This is the other group that meets on Thursday. Currently, there are 11 members in the team for that one, okay? The MCA made a poetry video back in 2019. We chose Julia's work for the Monday team. Whose work, by the way, this person's not here today, did we pick for the Thursday team? A. I'm gonna check one by one. Okay, good. The answer is, Ariana, what's the answer?
Caitlin.
Okay, it is Caitlin. Yes, the Thursday team have wrote about Be the One for their poem, and the Caitlin's one was collected. So yeah, everybody so far survived. I have no one out yet, so that's cool. In one of our YouTube video, there is an MCA scene where Sarai and Ariana sat together. Sarai asked, "What's wrong, Ariana?" And Ariana mentioned in her line that she was worried about this particular member from MCA. What is her name? I'll say it again. In one of our YouTube TV video, there is a line that says, "What's wrong, Ariana?" One of the famous quotes. Please raise up your panel, please. I want to see it. Please raise up your panel. Hey, Lota. Ariana, unmute yourself again. I know I keep calling you right now. This is your line. Remember your exact line? What was your exact line on this one?
It was about her.
Oh, that means you have survived the level one. Hey, everybody. I'll give you some good congratulations right now. High five your friend if you have it next to you. Yay, awesome job. All right, cool. Hey, I like the enthusiasm on some people. All right. On that one. Let's give it another high round of applause. Yay, y'all, for everything.
Yay. Right. Yay.
So the question was fairly simple, right? From now on, it's not going to be. This is where the real elimination starts. Before any film or movie is made, this written version is needed as a set of plans to guide the team of artists, craftspeople, and engineer as they produce a film. What is this written version called?
I think I got it wrong.
I don't know.
All right. What about you? Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Oh my god. I think I'm gonna get to get everybody out here.
Everybody?
Yeah, you're out. I'm writing down the people who got it wrong right now.
Got it wrong.
Oh, this is more than I thought. This is way more than I thought. All right. So. Okay, this is way more than I thought. All right. Okay, I'm going to give you one more chance, all right? But I'll tell you the answer. We're going to go to the next one. Next one, I'm not going to give anything. But this is just like... But the answer is... For the number six, screenplay. Screenplay was the answer. I'm going to slide this one, okay? All right, but here's what's going to happen. You're going to show me a good loud cheer and say, "Yay, thank you, Mr. Yoon."
Yay, thank you.
All right, cool. All right, so I saved you guys right now. So we're going to go to the next question. Now, next question, it has to do with what we used for the gear in our MCA. So somebody who have noticed this, this could be come to your advantage. So here we go. Our club has tried many type of camera gears and various type of equipment throughout the year. What is the brand name of the camera we used for all of our official video that we produced? If you ever paid attention to our camera, all of our camera had this logo on it. Raise up your panel. I want to see it. I'm going to write down the name. The answer is B, Canon. B, Canon is the answer. B-Canon is the answer. Yes, we have all cameras, and all the cameras that we have done was used with Canon. But I have two participants that will be out just for right now. All right, say bye.
Bye.
All right, so Kaylee and Jamie. We learned and talked about the importance of light in filming. We talked about the standard three-point lighting. What is the first and usually the most important light? This is the light that we have to use no matter what. Is it called A, backlight, B, key light, C, fill light, D, background light?
I guess I'm wrong.
Helen, raise it up. Helen, raise it up. Helen, raise it up. Okay, good.
You've never said these words, key light, when I've been around.
Actually, we did a bunch of times.
Not when I've been there.
We did a bunch of times. We did a bunch of times. All right, here we go. All right, the answer is B, key light. Key light is the answer. Key light is the answer. The purpose of the key light is to highlight the form and the dimension of the subject. It is a key source of all the lights. That's what they call a key light. Okay. Oh no, she just quit right away. All right. Miss S-Mine's out. By the way, you have beat your fifth grade teacher. Okay. So whoever survived, you are still on a roll. Right before we go into action and shoot the film, we yell out this word so everyone in the set can be quiet and be ready. What is the word that we use? Okay, I want you to raise it up right now, please. Raise it up if you know it. I am glad, and I am very glad that everybody remember this. It is called what, guys? Everybody say it.
Recording.
All right, recording. Yes. This software or an app is used digitally to alter or to edit a picture. The name of the software is also used as a term, especially when someone digitally manipulates the picture. What is the name of the software? Okay, good. I saw both Liana and Sarai there. All right, it is Photoshop. Yes, it is Photoshop. All right, great job. It is Photoshop. Yes, Photoshop was made in 1990 by a software company called Adobe, okay? And this was the first word that was created at the time. Didn't know it was going to be viral with somebody every time they edit a photo. So now we call it, whenever somebody edit a photo, they call it Photoshop, right? But it was actually started with a software company back in 1990. So prior to 1990, nobody used that word, Photoshop, ever. All right, here's what's going to happen. We're going to go to the next one. Now from here, it's going to be a little tough. This doesn't have a multiple choice question. Well, good luck. Okay, there we go. In most of the major software, this command is a shortcut key which makes you undo your last command or interaction. What is the shortcut key, or what is the shortcut control key for undo? In the most major software, this is a shortcut key. By the way, there's two buttons there, right? Think about the two buttons there, okay? You have to press this and that in order to make it undo. All right, let me see. Okay. The answer is Control Z. Control Z is the answer. All right, Control Z. Or you can also say Command Z. So Control Z, the programmers at Xerox PARC Research Center assigned a keyboard shortcut Control Z to undo command in 1976. Okay, so this was made in 1976. This same programmer went to a company called Apple. Okay, and then deliver the same type of command, and then it spread everywhere in the computer world. Remaining contestants, here we go. Listen to this song. Hold on for a second. I have to actually put this one. If I cannot put this song on, then I think you have to, I have to sing it for you guys, so. Ava's like, no.
Starry, starry night. Paint your palette blue and gray. Look out on a summer's day with eyes that know the darkness in my soul. Shadows on the hills.
This song was written by Adam McLean about Dutch artist who made a famous painting called Starry Night. What is the name of this Dutch artist? What is the name of the artist that Don McLean wrote a song about? We had this study as an art about a couple of months ago.
Mr. Yu.
Uh-huh.
What if we spell, is it okay if we like spell it wrong?
If you spelled it wrong, it's okay. I'm surprised somebody got it right. Good. Good. We got some gangster name here. All right, Banji. Okay, answer is Vincent. Vincent Van Gogh. Vincent Van Gogh is the name. So if you got anything, either Vincent, Van, or Van G, anything, you are correct, okay? When shouting aloud too close to the mic like this, an audio signal increases its gain, thus producing a fuzzy, growling, or gritty tone. What is the term used for that noise? All right, it is called distortion. Distortion is the answer. All right, good. Distortion is the answer. Yes, I know some of you guys have joined in, but you guys have to remain quiet because I'm still having five more people that are in basic color theory. There's opposing color. Like, for example, red and green creates maximum contrast and maximum stability. When two colors are directly opposite of each other, what are they called? Once again, paper's up once again. Lota, paper's up once again. The answer is complementary. If you got complementary, that is your answer. Okay? That is your answer. So, here's what's gonna happen. I have two remaining survivors on this complementary. Then they will go to the final round here. Actually, it's a music question, so. This Canadian singer and songwriter named Carly Rae Jepsen sang this popular song in 2011 and 2012 that gave out a significant mainstream popularity. What is the title of this song? Thumbs up, you two, if you're good. Okay, raise it up, please. The answer is... Yes, the answer is Call Me What? It... Wait! I'm gonna unmute everybody. Alright, Julia. I'm just gonna give you one more chance. One more chance, Julia. One more chance. Just because I gave everybody one more chance before. I'll give you one more chance. Alright, raise it up. Raise it up again. It is Call Me Baby. This is the last one. Hey, this one, I'm sorry, either you know this or not, okay? A popular Korean name, 방탄소년단, no, otherwise known as BTS, has how many member in its group? Has how many member in its group? It's a number, so you gotta give me a number. Either you know this or you don't. Raise up your panel, please. Raise up the panel. All right, so I'm gonna unmute everybody. It is great.
I honestly don't know.
I know.
Hey Siri.
I don't know.
Calculated everything, and I thought you guys did a great job out of it. Here's what's gonna happen. I'm going to give one of the account for the first winner, but I think the second winner did a really good job too. So I'm gonna try to give it out with the second player as well. Okay. So you guys did a both great job. The first annual McNeill Golden Bell Challenge award goes to
Lota,
which is 7. There is 7 members.
Oh, how many were there?
7. There's 7 members.
I had no idea. Yes.
Okay. Okay, so do me a favor, everybody give a good cheer for our fellow members here.
Good job. Right,
great job, guys. Great job. Give a good round of applause. Very good job. All right, so here's what's going to happen. The next question, whoever actually knows this, just can shout it out. Thermometer, I'll say it again. This is a science question, by the way. A thermometer measures the temperature. Thermometer measures the temperature, right? Okay. What does a barometer measure?
A what?
What?
What does a barometer measure?
Barometer.
I don't know what that is.
Okay, everybody Google it right now. I don't know if you have something.
Hey Siri.
You better know. We've done this before.
The thermometer measures the temperature.
What does
a barometer measure?
All right. I know.
Ariana,
air pressure.
Air pressure.
Yes.
Air pressure.
Shows when the weather is changing. Thank you, Siri.
That was supposed to be
Siri.
The correct one, okay?